Hi guys, on today's episode, we're cutting the cord. That's right, we're going from cable to fiber optics. So today, I'll show you the installation, our new speeds, and compare prices for both. Coming up next on the Ultimate Tech Hub.
So guys, let's go ahead and take a look at my network panel. This is the location of my cable modem, and I'll be replacing this with a fiber optic modem. But first, I'll need to run a fiber optic cable to this location. But where does the fiber optic cable come from? A typical location will be on the side of your house near your main electrical panel. This black fiber optic wire comes from the street. So from this location, I need to run a fiber optic cable up the wall, through the attic, and fish that wire down into my panel. So I decided to hire Mike from JDM Automations in Las Vegas to run that cable for me. He's done work for me in the past, and he's quick and affordable. His information will be in the description below. So first thing he did was drill a hole from the garage that went through the wall into the box on the outside of the house. This hole is where the cable's gonna run through. And the fiber cable will go up the wall through a small hole that goes into the ceiling, which leads to the attic. And from the attic, the fiber cable will run to my network panel, which is located in my master bedroom closet. After I get the fiber cable into the network panel, I can then install the fiber modem. I probably could have done this myself, but why take a chance of falling through the ceiling and, of course, hurting myself? So sometimes it's better to call a professional. And that's exactly what I did. All right, the fiber is now in my network panel. Now I need to call CenturyLink to connect the black fiber optic cable to my white fiber optic cable. Then we'll install the modem. And all we have to do is plug in the power supply, plug in the fiber optic cable to the modem, and plug in a Cat6 cable from the modem to my router. And that's it. And to be honest, I've been wanting to switch to fiber for a long time. So now let's go ahead and test our speed, our download and upload speed. CenturyLink says we'll get 940 megabits per second. But just a heads up, there are a lot of factors that will determine your download speed and your upload speed. So don't be surprised if you're not getting 940 megabits per second. So let's go ahead and do a speed test. And I'm not getting 940 megabits per second. But that's okay. Like I said before, there are many factors that determine network speed. One factor is, are there other people on your network using bandwidth? And how old is your computer? A slow processor can put the brakes on your connection, causing slower speeds. And how old is your router? Just like your PC, an old router can slow down your connection. And lastly, your web browser can slow your connection as well. So it's a good idea to experiment with different web browsers, like Google Chrome, Firefox, or Safari. And make sure your operating system is up to date. That will increase security and efficiency. So now let's talk about pricing. To get 1 gigabit speeds, we chose CenturyLink. And that's because they offer the fiber optics with installation and a modem, all for $65 a month. No contract, and the price never goes up. So let's compare pricing for gigabit speeds with Cox and CenturyLink. To get 1 gigabit speeds with Cox cable, it's gonna cost you $99 a month. However, if you bundle this with different services like TV services, this price drops to $69 a month. To get 1 gigabit speeds with CenturyLink, like I said before, it's only $65 a month. So we chose CenturyLink. And just a heads up, we had internet with Cox cable, as well as TV. And that price was around $170 a month. And our internet speed was only about 150 megabits per second. Pretty slow. So we decided to cut the cord, ditch the cable, and install fiber optics to get 1 gigabit speeds, all for $65. And now we'll stream cable services using Sling TV, which is $30 a month. So our total bill is $95 a month for internet and cable. So I hope this video gives you a clear understanding of fiber optics, how it's installed, the speeds, and the cost. And once again, I want to thank you guys for watching. If you like these videos, give a thumbs up and share it. If you love it, hit subscribe to keep this channel alive. Thanks again for watching.